This is Bluetti's new lithium iron phosphate heated battery, and it could be the perfect battery for you. Bluetti has three different models of this battery. This is the 314 amp hour model, but they also have a 51.2 volt 100 amp hour battery and a 100 amp hour model that is designed for trolling motors. Bluetti is well renowned for their power stations, but it's really cool that they decided to do a battery for camper vans, RVs, trailers, whatever it might be. I think they've done a really good job of the design of the case. It has some really cool features that a lot of other batteries actually don't have. You'll notice that the battery is a lot shallower than a lot of other standard batteries on the market. So it's a lot wider, but it's shallow, not quite as tall. I believe they did this because it is stackable. These little jet outs on either side here, they have them on the top and the bottom so that you can stack multiple batteries on top of each other. And they also have a cutout here in the middle where you can put a strap to secure the battery down in place, which is really nice. They have the positive terminal and the negative terminal, super solid connection points. And then they have communication ports here. The batteries actually come with an Ethernet cable. You can connect multiple batteries to each other so the batteries can actually talk to each other. And these actually just screw off, and then you'll see just a typical Ethernet port there. The other thing I really like about this battery is the fact that there is a power button. So it's kind of tucked over to the side here, but you can actually turn the battery on and off, which is really nice. Typically when you're installing a battery, you want to have your main on and off switch. And this way you don't actually have to have one. I also have a power on and off switch on my other battery, and I decided to remove the on off switch that I had previously because it just takes up a lot of room and you need to install more cables, more connections. So having this switch is really nice to be able to restart the battery just in case anything happens. Or if you're putting it away in storage, you can just turn it off. On the other side, opposite of the power on off switch, is actually a vent. When I first got the battery, I actually thought that this was the power switch, but it's actually just a safety vent just in case something happens inside the battery. Not only is this lithium iron phosphate battery heated, but it also comes with Bluetooth. Bluetti's app is okay. A lot of people have some complaints with it. I personally think it could be better, but hey, the battery does have Bluetooth and it allows you to monitor your battery remotely, which is really nice. This model can discharge and charge at a rate of 140 amps, which is a little bit lower than I would like to see if you're powering large electronics through an inverter, like say an electric stovetop or an air fryer. You are gonna be approaching more than that 140 amps. But I'm really interested to test this guy out and to see how it operates. The battery is also IP65 resistant, so you can't submerge this battery, obviously, but you don't have to worry about splashes and dust around it. This battery does weigh 65 pounds, but it is a big battery and you're not gonna be moving this around a lot. You're probably gonna be installing it in one place and leaving it there. It does have some really nice handles on either side. You can also connect this battery in series or in parallel, which is also really nice just in case you have a 48 volt system or a 24 volt system. Bluetti is also backing this battery with a 5-year warranty, and it is good for 6,000 cycles. It's 70% DOD, which is a little bit different from other lithium iron phosphate batteries on the market. A lot of manufacturers go with 80% DOD because lithium batteries typically operate the best between 20% and 80%. Once you go outside that range, that's when you want to slow down those charging cycles. So to get the max out of this battery, you're probably going to want to stay in between that 30% and 70% mark just to maximize the life of this guy. Right now, this battery is on sale for $1,000 Canadian. I'll put the American price too up on the screen. I'm actually not sure if this model is available in the US yet, but I'll be sure to link it below. All right, so I'm gonna turn this guy on and show you guys the app here. B1232. I have fully charged this battery, so it is sitting at 100% charge. We have 13.3 volts, it's on standby. The battery temperature is currently 8 degrees Celsius and the time remaining there, since there's nothing draining it, we have 615 hours and 26 minutes. Once we connect it, we'll take another look here. So you can go into the settings. There is a firmware upgrade. You can unbind it. You can put a Bluetooth connection password on it as well. So there aren't a lot of settings in here for this battery, but it is nice that you can see what's going on with it. This is without a doubt one of my favorite parts about this battery, and I'm not sure why other manufacturers aren't doing it, but the fact that it actually comes with a mounting kit. These brackets can be screwed down to the floor of your camper van, your RV, or whatever it may be on the sides here. And they actually even provide a jig so you can mount this down, screw all of your holes, and then perfectly mount these brackets down for the battery, which is so sweet. Unfortunately, they don't provide a strap, which I'm not too sure why, but you have to buy your own strap. And you can actually go all the way over top here if you have one, if you have two batteries. I guess they didn't provide a strap because they're not too sure what the length might be for your install. But it's awesome that they provide these components. It makes mounting the battery that much easier. And they also provide you with a ton of hardware with the kit too. You have these battery terminal covers here. Ethernet cable for the communication port. These are actually locking mounting bolts for the terminals right here. These are small leg bolts for these mounting brackets. And then they also provide, I believe these are actually concrete anchors, just in case you are mounting this to concrete inside of a garage floor or in the basement of the house or something. All right, so let's go out, hook this battery up, and put it through the paces to see how it performs. Got the battery installed here. It is connected to my entire solar system. So let's go ahead and test out this BMS and see what this battery can do. Right now we are only pulling a couple amps from the battery. Kaylee and I use this all the time when we are in the van, so I really am interested to see if this battery can handle this. All right, 160 amps. So this is a lot more than this battery is supposed to be able to handle. It's only supposed to pull about 140. So let's see if it actually shuts off or not, or if it can handle this, because this is actually going to be a huge factor for us, whether this is usable. So we are pulling, you can see on the top left is the amps, top right is the voltage, and it seems to be taking it just fine so far. All right, it's been going for about a minute and no problems. The battery doesn't seem to have an issue producing about 156 amps. There is more than enough hardware to get this battery mounted. They provide a ton of different bolts. So no matter what kind of situation you are mounting to, they definitely have it covered. One thing to note when you are installing this, depending on your setup, you can only install it this orientation. You can't install it vertically or horizontally. This is the only one that they recommend, so just keep that in mind. The other thing when comparing this battery to, say, the Renogy Core 300 amp hour battery, which is probably the closest model that you'd be comparing it to. The Renogy one is also self-heating. This one is about $140 cheaper. It comes with Bluetooth and it also has the power button. So I think this is a way better model to go with if you are comparing it to a Renogy or another model. It's not the cheapest battery on the market by any means. I have drained the battery all the way down to 78% as quickly as I could. It's been pulling about 146 amps. So I'm gonna go ahead, shut off this heater, plug it in and see if we can charge this thing at about 150 amps. It might shut off, it might not. Let's see what happens. All right, so I have my inverter set to charge it up to 150 amps. It looks like the BMS is actually controlling the current down to about 103, which is awesome. So it knows exactly how fast to charge this battery based on the level. I'm sure if this battery was lower, it would be hitting it with a lot more current. But that is good to see that the BMS is actually working correctly so the cells don't get damaged. So you can see current, voltage, battery temperature is up to 16 degrees Celsius.
and estimated charge time should be full in about 37 minutes. One feature that I really like about this actually is it says the Bluetooth signal in the top left corner here. So right now we have three bars because we're standing right beside the battery, but I've actually walked all the way around the outside of the van and this throws a pretty good signal compared to some of my other components. I would say it is a lot better than my other battery and pretty similar to my inverter charger and my solar charger. If you're wondering about how good the Bluetooth signal is on this battery, it is actually pretty decent.
It's time to put this self-heating battery to the test. I left this in my freezer last night and it is very, very cold. So we're gonna turn it on, hit it with some charge and see how the BMS handles it. Step one, we can turn it on here. Well, that's interesting. The light actually just went to red. We are sitting at -5 degrees Celsius for the battery right now. I got my battery charger right here. So let's go ahead and connect these guys up and see what happens. Okay, so current is going up. Oh, and then it's dropping back down and it's going back up right now. So it's kind of fluctuating a bit. The charger says, oh, it's bouncing around too. So let's see. I'm sure this is just the heating elements inside the battery turning on here. This is when it'd be really nice if it actually said in the app whether the heating elements were on inside. I know in the Renogy app, it does say that. There's also a light on top of my battery that says whether the heating is on. Okay, we're getting an exclamation mark. Got an alarm here. E086, charging low temperature. Protection. So it is stopping the charging right now, which is good. That's exactly what it should be doing. Okay, and the battery temperature just changed to -4 degrees Celsius. So it should be going up. Let's see how many amps it says is going into the battery charger. It says 15 amps is going in. Seems like a lot, but heat takes a lot of power. So it really depends how many heating elements are in this. So let's see how long it takes for this guy to heat up. So still getting that alarm. It's nice that you can actually see the alarms and see the code on here. So if anything else were to happen, you could actually tell. So it seems like it just keeps trying to accept the charge, but nothing is actually going through because the BMS keeps turning it off. Well, this might take a little bit of time, but let's see how long it takes to heat this battery up from -5 degrees Celsius. So after about an hour of charging, the battery actually successfully hit 0 degrees Celsius. And the light turned from red to green, indicating that it was able to charge. And now after about like an hour and 15 minutes, hour and 20 minutes, we're sitting at 8 degrees Celsius and the battery is accepting essentially a full charge of what my charger can output into this battery, which is about 15 amps. The BMS is working accurately and it is protecting the battery. It was acting a little bit strange there. It was fluctuating quite a bit for amps around 0 degrees, 1 degrees, 2 degrees. But I think that was due to just balancing those heating elements inside the battery a little bit. And it's hard to tell if the heating elements are on and off. And it doesn't actually say in the instructions when they kick on and when they kick off. I think they've completely kicked off now that it's at 8 degrees Celsius. If I were to guess, I would say they kick off around 5 or 6 degrees Celsius, but it doesn't state in the manual. And it would be really nice to know what those parameters are set at for the BMS. And also if the heating elements are on, it would be really nice in the app if they had an indicator. And also if this light, say, turned yellow or orange, indicating that the heating elements were on inside the battery, that would be a really great feature for Bluetti to add. As it gets colder and as we go out camping during January and February, I'm going to continue to test this and see how this battery operates. If you guys have any questions about this Bluetti lithium iron phosphate battery, be sure to comment below. Let me know your thoughts on it if you have any questions on it, and I'll see you guys in the next one.